Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1964, the IFS function. All right, that last podcast about the block Excel, that was just crazy. Let's get back to something really, really good here. Okay, so one problem that we've had for a long, long time is when we have to nest if statements. We have a bonus program. If you sell greater than $1,000, you get $100. Greater than $2,000, $200. Greater than $3,000, $250. Greater than $5,000, $500. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 if statements nested. You know, and boy, there used to be this really horrible limit of 7. Now you can go to 32, but you should never go to 32. You should switch over to doing the true, the range version of VLOOKUP. All right, so go look up A4 in this table. When you can't find the 5,342, give us the value that is just less. Both of those have been around forever, but in the brand new version of Excel, it just came out, Office 365, came out February 2016. They've offered another new function, the plural of if, the ifs function. Now, here's the one thing that is a tiny bit weird about ifs. So you start out with a logical test. If the sales are less than $1,000, then you get 0. All right. We then launch into the next logical test. So we want to check to see if the sales are less than $2,000, right here, then you get $100, right? And you just keep going on, adding logical test and what to do if that's true, logical test and what to do if that's true, logical test and what to do if that's true. The thing that got really weird for me as I was building this function is when I got down to the end, I wanted to have that final otherwise do this, and instead you have to put what that otherwise is. So in this case, anything greater than $5,000 gets the 500. It felt very much like a regular if function. I wanted to just be able to put a final single argument there, but instead you have to specify what it is. And now, of course, I had to be really careful. I couldn't just say greater than 5,000, because then if someone sold exactly 5,000, it would not know what to do. In fact, I just paused the video because I wondered what it would do if I hadn't done the greater than or equal to 5,000 and had exactly 5,000. We get an NA error saying that none of these conditions are true. I guess I could wrap it in an if NA, but boy, that's a hassle. Anyway, I applaud the Excel team. I know this is Joe and his crew came up with the beautiful ifs function, and what a great, great new feature. All right, so again, we are looking for Office 365. You have to be in the first release program or have home or student. You're looking for that version there to get this new functionality. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.